stopped by Martinuk, and Joe O'Connor collects behind his own net. Turn it over right circle. Breakaway for the Mustangs, and a shot is off the right side of the net from Davis Sheldon.
His only Junior A point came against the Mustangs in that 5-1 win. It was an assist. Now a 2-on-1 for the Bandits. Conley forced a turnover. Carries in right wing with Ursulak. Fed across. Ursulak shoots. Stopped by Semenuk.
Put it behind the net, but Sheldon got there first. Got knocked down hard with a big hit by Perkusic. Put it right half-boards. Makar fed in front. Save. Rebound. Cockrell shoots. Saved by Semenuk again.
There with 15 seconds in the power play. Put it top left circle. Makar's slap shot right on. Rebound jammed. That scores!
Derek Lodermeyer converts on the power play for Brooks. And the streak is over. They get a goal, a man up, and take the lead. Forwards and cut to the corner. Behind the net, right center to Perkusic. A point-blank one-timer is stopped and held by Carter Semenuk.
Right corner.
Bertanen there. Centers one wide open. Nick Xavier's one-timer stopped by Martinuk. And he holds on for a whistle stop.
Settled down by Baird. Put up the middle to Pereira. Now right wing Cockrell speeds past the defense. In on goal. Backhander stopped by Semenuk. And then bowling into Semenuk is Pereira.
Shot in the right half-court area.
Put it to the right circle. Cockrell settles it down. Got a shot away and he rang the near post.
Oh, Cockrell's come close. Bear along left point shot right on. Rebound, Cockrell shoots and scores! Rather, McKechnie got to it at the right side of the net off the rebound of the floating Shane Bear point shot. And number 13 of the Bandits from the right side of the Mustang cage rings the iron for the second time on this shift after Cockrell did it just seconds ago.
Marchand is cut off. Mustang center one bounces off a puck to Stormone mid-blue line. Shoots a long one. Scores!
Sam Stormone with a low shot from just outside the ringette line.
And Hirokiu and taken by Sheldon. He's 1-on-1 against Bear. Sheldon left circle, got around his man, shoots.
Oh, what a glove save by Troy Martinuk down on the seat of his pants. He absolutely robs the Mustang forward. But Brooks is going to take a penalty on that play despite the highlight reel.
Bertanen, right circle, center to Vermeulen, left hash mark, shoots off a body,
loose in front, Kendrick Xavier. Oh, he's robbed by Martinuk with a left kick save on the chance for Xavier wide open in front of the Bandit net. Nactical carries in left wing.
To the half boards, holds on. Fed one across, a wide open chance, fed back door, and Yurik scores! Behind the play, a Bandit had been knocked down and is injured.
Lodo
to Lodermeyer, who skates left corner. Knifes it up to the left point for Nactigal across to Makar, right point. Makar waits and shoots off a body. Jim that Cockrell scores!
Kale Makar took the initial shot and it went off his stick and just bounced constantly down into the Mustang slot. Cockrell was able to
there. Skating left corner, put it right point. Taylor Carl to the right half boards. Airmails one over the net. Came to O'Connor left half boards. Down to the corner. O'Connor skates in behind the net. Defenseman spending a lot of time down low. O'Connor cuts into the high slot. Turnaround shot off the back of Vermeulen. Rebound Aiello scores!
Mateo Aiello's first Junior A goal. It's a one-timer from the slot on the rebound of a nifty chance set up by Joe O'Connor with some smooths.
Goals free to Cockrell, though, at the end boards. He's pinned by McDonald. Still got it free to Pereira behind the net. Centering one, McKechnie wide open, scores!
Nobody picks up Josh McKechnie, who walks into the Mustang slot and is wide open on the feet in front by Jesse Pereira to knock one in past a standing Carter Semenuk, who's hung out to dry by his team. And McKechnie's got his second of the evening.
Would have been a Calgary lead if not for him. He's had to make some more saves here in this third after this three-goal lead. Here's Conley right circle, shoots one right on.
Rebound by Aiello, scores! His first two Junior A goals. Both come on rebound opportunities as nobody picks up number 25. The former Calgary Flames midget AAA leading goal scorer has the first two of his Bandits career, tapping that one in from just below the left hash marks, and the Bandits have made it a 6-2 game.
Smart as he is in those situations. Now the Bandits force a turnover at neutral. Makar speeds in, got around the defense, shoots right on.
Rebound, Aiello, backhander, and he just misses the net.
Right again with Perkusic. Makar shoots a high one that's saved and held, and then Vermeulen cross-checks at Perkusic, and the referee may let it go. And then Perkusic's going to get jumped here by a reckless Vermeulen here. Perkusic did not drop his gloves. Now he's trying to, but the linesmen are already in between the two of them. That's Vermeulen jumping Perkusic before he has a chance to drop his gloves, trying to sneak in some punches on a defenseless opponent. He'll be gone from this game. And it does end up being a 7-minute penalty here to Vermeulen of the Mustangs, as it well should be. 2 for instigating, 5 for fighting, and a game misconduct. Junior A hat trick here on the power play with the Bandits a lengthy lead. Here comes McKechnie speeding in right side, looking for his first career hat trick. He cuts it on goal. Backhander, he scores!
Hat
trick, Josh McKechnie, as he barrels into the Mustang zone completely untouched, dangles around a defender at the right circle, goes forehand to backhand, and tucks one around a sprawling Carter Semenuk on the power play. The Bandits are up 7-2, and McKechnie has back to the point. Try to feed it across, went off a Mustang stick, and they got a man behind the defense, could have a breakaway. They do, right in on Urich, but he's offside. The end boards by Baird out to neutral ice, and that will do it as it rolls all the way down to the Calgary zone. The Bandits pull away in the third, and they demolish the Calgary Mustangs on the road. It's a 7-2 final for the Brooks Bandits.